In this video, we talk about logic gates, NAND, AND, NOR, and so on. We are going to start from the basics, and we are going to build the logic gates from scratch, so directly from transistors, using C-MOS technology, mostly used in CPUs and RAM memories. In order to understand how computers manage bits, we have to create a toolbox. Therefore, starting from transistor, we are going to create something useful for working with bits. Logic gates. So, if you are ready, let's go started! I prefer start with the basics, so from our little and very fast switches, the transistors. We use two types of transistors. N-type and P-type. For our purposes, we just think of the transistor as a switch. The N-type transistor is on, closed circuit, if I apply a 1 or higher voltage to the gate, and it's off, open circuit, if I apply 0 or lower voltage to the gate. The P-type works the opposite. It is off if I apply 1. And it's on if I apply 0. Summarizing, our transistors are switches. I can very fast turn on and off, and that are very, very small. For our aims, this is all we need to know about transistors. Don't get confused about the word gate. We talk about the gate of the transistors, where we apply the voltage to turn the device on and off, and the logic gate, obtained by combining the transistor with each other. So now we start to create something useful with our switches. Our first gate is the NAND gate. We built it with four transistors coupled 2x2 P-type with N-type. We see the gate of P-type transistor A is connected with the gate of N-type transistor B, and the gate of transistor C is connected with the gate of transistor D. In such a configuration, if we put a 1 in both the inputs, the N-type transistors turn on and the P-types turn off, thus connecting the output with our 0. You can see the only way to have 0 on the output is applying 1 in both the inputs. In all other cases, if there is at least a 0 in one of the inputs, we get a 1 on the output. This because at least one of the N-type turns off and one of the P-types turn on, thus connecting the output with the higher voltage, so with our 1. Now we can raise our level of abstraction by putting the circuit inside the NAND symbol. We summarize the NAND gate's operation with the truth table. You can see again the output is 0 only when both A and B, the inputs, are 1. Now some comments about our NAND gate and our transistors. As you can see, for our first gate, we coupled an N-type with a P-type transistor. This kind of coupling is the base of C-MOS technology. C is for complementary, because we have P and N-type, and MOS is the kind of transistor we use. This technology is very important in electronics and in integrated circuits, as for example CPU or RAM memory, because of the low power dissipation and the possibility to put a huge number of transistors in your piece of silicon. The NAND gate is very important in digital electronics because it is one of the fastest gates and has another important feature. You can build every other gate with it. For example, you can build the NOT gate, connecting the inputs of the NAND. And you can build the AND gate, adding a NOT to the output of a NAND. And of course, you can build a OR gate, and so on. But, as you remember, you used 4 transistors to build a NAND. And so, in this way, we will need 4 transistors for a NOT, 8 for an AND gate, and 12 for a OR. Definitely too many. In electronics, you have to be prudent with transistors, so we prefer to use as few transistors as possible. So, here, how we build the NOT gate. We build it with just two transistors, a N-type and a P-type. The N-type is connected with a lower voltage, our 0. The P-type is connected with a higher voltage, our 1. We see this way only takes two transistors and not four, as if we used a NAND. Now, let's see how the gate works. We remember the transistors work as switches, so if we put a 1 on the gate, the N-type is on and becomes closed circuit, connecting the output with the 0, and the P-type is off and it is an open circuit. On the contrary, if we put a 0 on the input, the P-type is on, thus connecting the output with the higher voltage, our 1. So, if there is a 0 in input, the output is 1, and vice versa. If there is a 1 in input, the output is 0. Always the opposite. That's the reason of the name, NOT gate, or inverter. We can raise our level of abstraction and put our little circuit inside a triangle and have our NOT symbol without transistors. There is a way to summarize the operation of the logic gates, the truth table. As you can see, the output is always inverted in respect to the input. Now we see the AND gate. It is composed by an AND plus a NOT gate or inverter, so it is built with 6 transistors, not 8 as if we built it using just NAND gates. In this gate, the only way to have a 1 on the output is applying 2 1s on the inputs. If you remember the NAND gate working, we just put an inverter on the AND. So if I apply a 0 at least in one of the 2 inputs, I get a 0 on the output, because at least one of the P-type transistor is on, and the inverter turns in 0 the 1 on the output of the NAND gate. We can now raise our level of abstraction with the AND symbol. Our truth table summarizes the AND gate operations. We get a 1 on the output only if we have a 1 in both the inputs. Hence the name AND. Here another useful gate, the NOR gate. As you can see, we only use 4 transistors. In the NOR gate, the only way to get a 1 is applying 0 to both the inputs. In this case, the P-type transistors turn on and the N-types turn off. If we put a 1 in at least one of the 2 inputs, at least one N-type transistor turns on, thus connecting the output with our 0. We can raise now our level of abstraction with the NOR symbol. In the truth table, you can see the only way to get 1 is putting both A and B inputs to 0. Here we build the OR gate using a NOR and a NOT gate. So we need 6 transistors. Now we are used to this kind of analysis, and we see that in this circuit the only way to get a 0 on the output is applying 0 to both the inputs. In this way, the N-type transistors turn off and both the P-types turn on, thus connecting the output of the NOR with the higher voltage, our 1. Afterwards, the NOT gate inverts the 1 in 0. On the contrary, if I put a 1 at least in one of the 2 inputs, I get a 1 on the output of the whole circuit. Here, the truth table, where you can see the output is always 1, except when the inputs are both 0. And this is the OR symbol. This is our last gate. It is called XOR gate, or exclusive OR gate. In this gate, the output is 1 only if the inputs are 10 or 01, so only if the inputs are different. Now we apply 20 on the inputs, and we get a 0 on the output because the P-type transistors are on and the output gets the 0 in input A. If I change input A in 1, this one propagates until the output through the second P-type, kept in on by the 0 in input B. If we put a 1 in input B, we see the output turns back in zero, because now the p-type transistors are off, and the n-types are in on, so the output is connected with a lower voltage, our zero. We can now raise our level of abstraction with XOR symbol, and this is the XOR truth table, where you can see that you get a 1 only if the inputs are different. At this point, we can forget transistor and work only with logic gates. First, we build an AND gate with 3 inputs. It's very easy, we just need 2 inputs AND gates. We remember how AND gate operates. In order to have 1 on the output, all the inputs have to be 1. And this is the truth table. You can see the output is 1 only if all 3 inputs are 1. Now we are going to build something more complicated with our 3 input AND gates and with some NOT gates. Here you are, the decoder. Let's see what happens if we apply 3-0 to the inputs. You see that there is only one AND gate with 3 1s in its inputs. So we have the first output line with a 1 and all the others with a 0, because in all the other cases there is at least a 0 in one of the AND inputs, thus blocking the gate. Let's see what happens if I apply 001. You see that now it is the second line with a 1 and all the others have a 0. If I would apply 010, it would be the third line with a 1, and so on. So by applying 3-bit code on the input, you select one and only one of the output. We'll see in the next videos how useful it can be. Now we can raise our level of abstraction with the decoder symbol, which has 3 inputs and 8 outputs.